either on the nail.
G'day, I'm Paul. We're from the band Devil Skin, and you're listening to
Rhino Radio.
Hell yeah, turn it up.
And now of Devil Skin, how are you guys doing?
Really good, man.
Fabulous.
Well, great to be here. Thanks.
Thanks for having me. Thanks for entertaining me with some information about the future of Devil Skin.
Honestly, it's a treat for us to be in Birmingham, which is obviously the home of heavy metal. So, very special gig for us to be playing here.
You got some pictures with the stars?
Not yet.
So you have to. There's the Tommy one, there's the Aussie one, there are a few more that you might recognize.
Unfortunately, by the time we got into town, it was a little bit late to go having too much of an explore. But
what time is bedtime?
Well,
we don't have a bedtime.
We don't have a bedtime, no.
Okay. Well, I don't know if you remember, but we've actually met the last time you were here. I caught you just outside a pub.
Okay.
Very typical.
Okay.
So I was wondering, you guys have been touring the world. Can you compare the drinking culture between New Zealand, Birmingham, the world, food wise, also pit stops around the world? Where is it the best?
Well, pit stops are continuing not to go.
Everywhere in France.
Yeah, some of the truck stops in France are pretty sketchy.
And how's the drinking culture between the UK and New Zealand?
Well, it's obvious that the Germans like their beer,
okay.
And the quality of their beer is awesome as well. And, you know, we're partial to the odd beer as well, so that's pretty cool. I mean, it's pretty similar, really, isn't it?
Yeah, very similar, yeah.
If we go to New Zealand, same.
Pretty much the same. Yeah, people drink beer all day long, and then they binge on the weekends, so...
Yeah.
So you compete with the locals as well?
Well, we try our best to uphold our game, you know. We're talking big game, though.
Okay, we'll check that later. Okay, also about New Zealand, if I'm mistaken, the beginning was a bit rough. You didn't get enough plays on the radio. And even though, if I'm mistaken, Paul, you were in the radio, it was a bit tricky to...
It was a handicap working for the... I was working for the rock station, which was a nationwide network. But because I was doing a heavy metal show, I was that metal guy. So when I'm saying, hey, my band's got a new song, they were like, ugh. So it fully took them, I think, a year before they even listened to it. And then they gave it a little shove, our first single, a song called Little Pearls. And it got a few plays here and there, but people kept running up and asking for it. So it came about quite organically from the crowd putting pressure on the radio station, which was really good to see. And we followed up pretty quickly and kept the foot on the throat sort of thing. So we've established ourselves with New Zealand rock radio quite well now.
Also breaking through to the world between the long swim that you have from New Zealand to the rest of the world. Are you thinking about moving somewhere else?
I don't think we're going to be moving anytime soon, but I think, you know, the digital age and the internet has brought the world a whole lot closer. I mean, New Zealand once upon a time was, and still is, you know, geographically very, very, it's pretty much as south as you can get, but, you know, the wonderful world, the internet, you know, has moved our music a lot closer to European and the American markets as well, so.
For tours as well?
Yeah, I think we've realised that, you know, home's home, but we can go anywhere and tour. It's just a long trip.
It's just a plane ride away.
Yeah, it's just a plane ride. We can do it.
Okay. And you've been touring quite a lot, I think. Just a few weeks ago, you were touring with Hailstorm all around Europe?
Yeah, went all over Europe with Hailstorm. 18 dates, something like that.
18 dates through Europe. Started in Tilburg, and we went right through Germany, France, the Netherlands.
Belgium,
Sweden, Denmark, Austria, Norway.
Yeah.
So instead of moving, just packing a suitcase and going on the road.
That's
always
it.
The same.
One on the back of a small coffin-shaped bus, and off you go.
Okay. So with your experience in radio, have you given the band any tricks, any tips to either dealing with the media or?
Nah, because I mean, radio's changed so much. Back home, we've got one rock station really, and one that's slightly alternative. So there's overseas, there's just so much more of everything. There's dedicated rock and metal stations. So, as far as musically, you know, we just do what we do, and we don't think about radio or anything like that. We just play what we play and write how we write. And if something is suitable for radio station, then great. If it's not, too bad. You know, we just do what we do anyway.
And how's it moving from one side of the mic to the other side, asking questions and now answering questions?
Yeah, I don't mind. I'd rather answer than ask, I think, myself.
And what about being a bit more with the criticism side about the questions as well? I've seen you.
My pet hate is when people go, so is it Devil's Skin or Devil's Kin? And it's it's like,
yeah.
Motherfucker, where did you see a hyphen or a gap? There's none, you know, so that's why pet hate.
Why pet hate is where people ask us what sort of superhero we'd like to be.
So yeah. I'm not going to ask you that.
Okay.
I do want to confront you with two rumors.
Yeah, right.
Okay, do you like rumors?
Sure.
Great. So you can either diss them or confirm everything.
Okay.
So I got two. The first one is that because the band, there's some sort of a look, some sort of an image on stage,
Then
there's a rumor that Jenny's going to grow a goatee as well. Is that true?
I think it's
on the cards.
I think it's on the cards.
We'll be putting some pressure on it.
So 2019, that's happening.
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Yeah, expect a goatee from us, yeah.
Okay, and the second rumor, and I heard that you guys have a weird group of following that actually think that you guys are associated with the devil.
Oh yeah.
Yeah,
oh
yeah.
Yeah, we get a lot of mentions on our page from, you know, messages from people, and especially in
African
North
countries.
Africa and
yeah,
stuff like
yeah.
that, and they want to join us because we are the devil, and we string them along for weeks, man. We have so much fun with them. It's a great read.
Yeah, we want to join. How much to join?
Are you the devil? Okay.
Just send him to the merch page.
Yeah, yeah, we do.
Yeah, we should do actually. Yeah.
Okay, and you guys are some sort of a family band, okay? Without mentioning the fact that you guys are not actually twins, okay? I think your son is playing with you.
That's right.
As a drummer.
Nick's the drummer.
I think Jenny is your sister-in-law.
That's right. Yeah.
Okay.
Nick's auntie.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, how does it feel on one hand taking your family with you? I mean, there's got to be some issues with it, sending Nick to do his homework.
Main issue is leaving my wife at home by herself,
okay.
You know, taking all the menfolk out of town and everything for the weekend. But, yeah, we don't have any issues on the road. Everything's really smooth. We don't argue, we don't fight. Everyone just knows our place. We all know what we want to do. We're all striving to do our very best. And, We've had enough experience putting up with each other now that we're used to it, so yeah, it's a lot of fun.
How about you dealing with the family?
Yeah.
It's second to the family.
Well, I mean, I feel like part of the family anyway, you know, even though I'm not biologically related, but I mean, you know, we stream and want to tell everybody we're evil twins, so.
We're looking into adopting them, so.
Okay, and what about other family members that want to join the band? Because I think I've seen some kids on some videos, some instruments.
Yeah. Oh yeah, there's a lot of that. But yeah, my oldest son Jake really wants to tour with the band doing catering. He's a wicked chef, so that'll be the next step maybe.
So maybe she's keeping it away. I think Jenny is a new mom as well.
Yeah.
So how do you? Okay, so how's it leaving everyone behind?
It's tough. You know, I've got a new kid as well, so my oldest son Tim, I'm sorry as well. I've got a couple of kids a bit behind as well. It's tough, man, but I mean that's all part of the territory, you know. As I said before about the digital age, I can still say goodnight to my kids through FaceTime or Skype, or you know, I can still say good morning to them before school. And, so
it's your morning here and it's their goodnight there.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. If I get up early enough, I can. Yeah.
Ending it on the family note, who's the best at knowing all the lyrics to Disney songs?
That'd be Nick.
Yeah, Jenny.
There's not going to be a Frozen cover anytime soon?
Oh, now loads of Frozen stuff.
Yeah, I'm pretty good with the Frozen stuff. I've got girls.
Which one's your favorite?
What, Frozen the character?
Well, either character or song.
The only one I know is Let It Go.
Are you
going to
top it up?
I haven't seen the movie.
For the next tour.
Yeah.
For the next tour, yeah. Okay, guys, so what's in the future? The end of the release a couple of weeks ago. Can we expect a full release?
Yeah, we've got another song that we're getting ready to do. We've got concept ideas for another video and another single release when we get home. It'll probably be early next year. But we'll be definitely aiming towards an album release next year, 2019. So keep an eye for that.
Okay, concept-wise, are you going to swap characters? Is Jenny going to be the cowboy? You guys are going to be the pinup guys?
Yeah, it could well be. We're looking at our options at the moment.
Okay, so what can we expect in the future? 2019 is going to be a big year again?
Yeah,
it's going to be a very big year.
We need to come back here to the UK and to Europe and then consolidate on what we've done this time.
Yeah.
We've got a few good gigs coming up when we get home and a little bit of a tour to Australia.
We're going to be opening Slash Miles Kennedy for Australia and New Zealand in January. And then we'll be performing here as a festival at home called Homegrown as well. And some other stuff coming on in March. So we need to put some time aside for our studio.
Yeah, we do.
Okay, anything else you want to add to fans and listeners out there?
Thank you for the support. And, you know, the song's been getting caved on